When I was in the ninth grade, I volunteered to be on my high school's diving team. Every year, our school would compete in an annual swimming and diving competition, and I volunteered to fill the third and final slot. It was a problem, though. See, the reason that I volunteered was, after the first two had volunteered, nobody else wanted to fill that third slot, so I said, well, I'll do it. The problem was that I had no clue how to dive whatsoever, especially competitive diving. So I thought, this is no big deal, diving is easy, I can do this. So I didn't practice. The first time that I went to the pool to actually attempt to practice, it was the day before the competition. And my two teammates were there, and I said, so what dive do I have to do? And one of them said, well, first you have to do a forward dive. Okay, I can do that. Then you have to do a back dive. Finally, you have to do a somersault. Oh, darn. I used a much more choice four-letter word than darn, but anyway. So the day of the competition comes in. If I had practiced whatsoever, done a few minutes of the forward dive or the back dive, then practiced this somersault because, well, I can only risk an injury. Step up onto the 1 meter wall. All the other kids doing their dives from the 3 meter wall, not me. Because I didn't like it. So I do the forward dive, I run along that board, and I jump up into the air, and well, I thought I did pretty well. My hands were clenched, and my knees were bent, my back was a little scoliotic. Just to see what my score was. Now, other kids getting 6 out of 10, 7, 9 out of 10, they give me 3/4 of a point. And then I'll say to myself, don't worry, I'll do better with the next dive. My turn comes to do the back dive. So I step up onto the board right to the very edge, and as you do the back dive, I put my toes right on the edge, and I balance myself. I adjust my bathing suit, and I jump up and back. Now when you do the back dive, you're not supposed to actually land on your back. You're supposed to enter the water perfectly perpendicular to it. So maybe I was a degree or two off at the most. I need the judges to see what my score is. Half a don't panic, I say to myself, I'll do better with the somersault, because that's a dive with a much greater degree of difficulty. Now for those of you who may not understand intricacies and terminology of competitive diving, a greater degree of difficulty means that in my lifetime, I've never done a somersault before, on purpose. So I hear the announcer call my name, and she says, John, come let me do a forward somersault in the pike position. Pike position? What the dickens is that? I didn't write that down when I entered my dives. But I don't know the pike position from the missionary position. Even today, my wife says, I still don't know. I step up onto the board, the 1 meter board, and I run down the length of that board as fast as my flat feet can carry me. And I launch myself at least a foot into the air. Miraculously, I began somersaulting. I don't know how many times I somersaulted. I'm not sure which direction I was somersaulting. My eyes were closed, I couldn't tell, I didn't know where the water was. I hit the water like a skipper potato. A friend of mine said to me afterwards, when he was watching, he said, like a death spiral. I stayed under the water for as long as I could. 10 minutes out of the water. And when I emerged from the water, I had no applause, no cheering, just laughing. They were laughing at me. I looked at the judges to see my superpower. I had a blast because I had somersaulted. To save the team. The judges cautioned me. I had let my school down, I had let my team down, and myself with a total of 1.5. I was an embarrassment. But had I really let the team down? Because out of 500 boys in my school, the only one who volunteered for that final position. You know, after they counted all the points of each of the dives and all of the swimming races, my school won the overall competition